What's up? You are now rocking with the Bigs. My name is Herb Howard. This is the Bears post-game report. The Bears were able to even their record to 1-1 following a victory over the Cincinnati Bengals in a game in which the Bears seemingly dominated from start to finish, although they were only able to walk away with a final score of 20-17. The Bears defense was making plays all over the field. They forced four turnovers. They created four sacks of Joe Burrow. They were making plays, three interceptions, one fumble recovery. However, the offense simply was not able to capitalize on all of those turnovers and the good field position that the defense was giving them, resulting in only a 20-17 victory, again in a game that the Bears were fully in control of from start almost clear to the finish. Late in the game, the Bears offensively and defensively started to make some mistakes and allow the Cincinnati Bengals to get back into it, making this game much closer than it seemed like it would be. Again, the defense, four turnovers, four sacks. Anytime you have a game like that, you expect to win that game by 20 or more points. That simply was not the case. The offense is going to have to find ways to continue to capitalize on their opportunities. Allen Robinson, normally a very sure-handed receiver, dropped two apparent touchdowns, one on a deep ball from Justin Fields straight down the sideline that went right through his hands, another on another pass from Justin Fields, a back shoulder one, more contested, still a ball you would like to see Allen Robinson come down with. He wasn't able to do so today, and again, the Bears were only able to walk away with a 20-17 victory. There were many, many positives, though. Second-year pro, the Bears' number one cornerback, Jalen Johnson, got his first career interception. He said it was very, very nice to play in front of a packed stadium here at Soldier Field. His rookie season obviously was in the middle of the COVID football season. He's never seen 60,000 fans in Soldier Field screaming, supporting the defense in the way that they were today. Roquan Smith continues his ascent to be undoubtedly one of the very best linebackers in the league. Not only did he have a sack today, he also had an interception, which he returned 53 yards for a touchdown on a play that seemed to put the icing on the cake for the Bears. Again, they made some mistakes down the stretch, and the game got much closer than it should have been, but Roquan is absolutely phenomenal. He's playing really, really good football for this team, and you expect only for him to get better and better and better as time goes along. Akeem Hicks also had a really, really good game, as did Eddie Jackson. Speaking to Akeem Hicks after the game, I asked him about one play in particular in which he sprinted 30 yards from his defensive tackle position all the way out to the sideline and put an absolutely vicious hit on Tee Higgins, the Cincinnati Bengals wide receiver. He simply said, you have to hustle. You have to continue to sprint and put yourself into positions to be able to make that play. He works hard at it. He was proud of the play, proud of the way the defense performed as a whole. They were able to bounce back with a very strong performance following their poor performance last week in LA against the Rams. The Bears defense looks to get back on stride. They go to Cleveland next week. We will see if they're able to keep up this level of play, but they'll need more help from their offense. Andy Dalton, the Bears starting quarterback, did go out of this game in the second quarter with an apparent knee injury. Rookie first round pick Justin Fields came in and finished the game at quarterback. Mixed results for him. He didn't really play all that well. Didn't play that bad. He did make some mistakes, did make some rookie mistakes. He threw a key interception late in the game that set the Bengals up for a touchdown again as they begin to get back into the football game. All in all, I think Justin Fields will continue to get better and better, and he will ascend. We will find out if he is going to be the Bears starter week three going into Cleveland, as Andy Dalton will be evaluated over the next couple of days to see how his knee injury is actually progressing. But the Bears, again, able to walk away victorious, even their record up at 1-1 against the Cincinnati Bengals. They look ahead to week three when they will travel to Cleveland to face the Browns. This has been the Bears post-game report, rocking with the Bigs. My name is Herb. It's us.